Enfusoft.
Hello, let me introduce you to Enfusoft, a tool I co-created to help me create patterns quickly. Okay, let's cover the basics of this tool, starting with the grid subtool. The home screen displays the Enfusoft website when connected to the internet. This will allow you to access tutorials, hotkeys, FAQs, and allow me to message you with updates. The asset palette lives on the right. This is where you will load your asset library. Enfusoft comes preloaded with some of my sample illustrations, so you can test out the features. If you'd like to load your own images, then you'll have to unlock that feature in the paid version. Enfusoft is a processing tool where you import existing images in PNG, JPEG, and bitmap file formats. You then can export the resulting patterns in a PNG, JPEG, and bitmap file format as well. There are no working files to be saved while you're processing patterns. Okay, let's get to it. On the top left, there are three icons: New Grid, New Pack, and New Toss. We've divided up the tool into what type of patterns they create. Let's say you want to start with a grid pattern. You'll notice once you click the Grid subtool, a new ribbon appears on top with a tab that reads Grid. Also, right below the top ribbon, another tab with Grid pops up. This is your Documents tab, where you can switch back and forth between different documents when you have multiple patterns being made at the same time. You'll also notice at the very top of the tool it reads Grid Enfusoft, which simply reminds you which subtool is active. The ribbon on top contains all the parameters you need to adjust your grid. The ribbons are all different per subtool. There are some functions that span all the subtools. The Tiling button and the Canvas button toggle a view mode of your pattern. Tiling reveals what your pattern looks like when tiled. Canvas shows the border of your canvas in green. The rainbow droplet changes the background color. When you open the rainbow droplet, you get to see what your pattern looks like in front of a certain base color. You can also adjust the opacity of the background. Even if the opacity is set to zero, the color you last set will still be displayed in the viewport. On the opposite side of the ribbon, we have the Export and Generate or Run buttons. The Generate button in the Grid and Toss ribbons generates a new pattern based on your latest inputs. In the Pack ribbon, the Generate button is now a Run and Stop button. It essentially is the same thing, but the Pack tool runs an active simulation which you have the choice to stop. More on that in the Pack tutorial. The navigation bar is a simple zoom and pan. The same navigation bar exists in the Toss tool. Hotkeys for this are Z for zoom and spacebar for pan. After you hit Z, click and drag up to zoom in and down to zoom out. The export buttons save out your pattern. Just choose a location you'd like to save the file out in. Okay, we've just covered the basic set of tools that universally exist on all three ribbons. Next up, I'll dive deeper into the specifics of the grids tools. As the name implies, the grid tool makes a grid pattern. The first thing you would want to do is to go to your asset palette and load images. This will give you something to work with. What matters most in the grid tool is your column and row count. The next important thing is to set the width and height in pixels of each individual grid. I would suggest inputting a size close to the image asset you've authored. Then you can set the spacing between grids. You can even set a negative number to bring grid items closer together. The sum of the last three settings ultimately drives the final canvas size. So it may be a bit counterintuitive, but for the grid tool, you have to think of building your canvas size from your smallest piece and work outward. Also be mindful of how large your document size needs to be. I would advise you to work toward the output needs of your deliverable. For example, fabric printers may only need images that are 150 dpi, which means you can shoot for a swatch size of 18 inches by 18 inches to be 2700 pixels by 2700 pixels. Okay, let's continue to work down the list of parameters you can adjust. To the right of the canvas size dialog area are inputs that do not change the canvas size: scale ranges, scale type, and angle ranges. I would note that as long as you're not changing the column or row count after you hit generate, any adjustments you make in these boxes will not generate a new pattern, but only affect the items locally. The only way you'll get a new pattern distribution is if you hit generate or change the row and column count. Scale ranges is quite simple. Just type in a min and max scale size, and the items will jitter in size within that range. Angle ranges give you the ability to set the items to rotate in a very specific way. 0 and 360 are at 12 o'clock. So if you'd like the items to rock back and forth a bit, you can set the ranges to negative 20 and 20. If you'd like the items to all be at a 45 degree angle, you can set it to 45 and 45. Let's go over the scale types. There are three scale types: fit, stretch, and original. The default scale type is set to fit. For fit, images take on the grid size you've set. The grid size is the master, and all images will keep their aspect ratio and fit into that grid. What stretch does is it prioritizes grid dimensions and stretches images to those parameters. In this case, if the grid aspect ratio is not the same as the authored image, it will stretch the image to fit. Original prioritizes the asset's original dimensions and size, ignoring grid parameters. In the case that the grid size is smaller than the image, then the image will bleed over into each other. This concludes the tutorial of the grid subtool. The next tutorial will cover the pack subtool. The pack subtool is a second pattern type. Notice the pack tool document tab and the pack name on top of the tool. On the left, you'll see a toolbar. This is what you'll use to manipulate all the image assets on screen. The asset palette is still on the right, so load your assets here. If you mouse over any function, the tool name, tooltip, and if applicable, a shortcut key will be displayed. Let's cover the packs toolbar. After you load your assets, click the brush tool icon on the toolbar. Then click and drag in the canvas and you will spray the assets. The tool will randomly distribute everything in your asset palette. If you have individual assets selected, your brush will only spawn those selected assets. By default, there is no simulation running, so the assets are all suspended on the canvas. The image assets are spawned in to not overlap each other and to stay within the canvas boundaries. There are cases, however, that the assets become overlapping because they just get pushed into each other. This will cause either the assets to get stuck to each other or fall off the canvas area. If there is a gravity simulation running, the asset will eventually disappear. The pan and zoom tools help you navigate within your canvas. The marquee selection allows you to click and drag a marquee to select a group of objects. The selected objects will then be shaded a blue color to show they've been selected. You can then scale your selection as a group. The eraser tool erases image assets on the canvas, but if you double-click the eraser button, you can erase your entire selection. Both the grab tool and the move tool move the asset you touch, but grab keeps the physics simulation going. The pivot point is exactly where you've chosen to grab the asset. Move locks the whole asset while you move. The rotate tool allows you to rotate a selected asset. The scale tool allows you to scale a selection. The packs ribbon contains all the parameters you'd need to control and create pack patterns. Hotkeys 1, 2, and 3 toggle the view mode. 1 shows both image and physics. 2 shows image only. 3 shows just the physics shape. The canvas size can be determined in pixels. There's a limit to what your computer can handle in file size, so be mindful of this while you're picking your canvas size. The next section deals with the physics properties dropdown, where you can select custom physics shapes. The default physics shape applied to all assets is a sphere, simply because it's fast to calculate and rolls around. The next is box, which is also quite fast, but is a bit more clunky. For more accuracy, outline creates physics shapes close to the silhouette of your image. Outline is the most accurate, but is the slowest because it has much more to calculate. Below the physics dropdown, there is a collision offset box. This adds a padding border of collision around your initial physics shape. The units are in pixels. This feature helps add spacing between objects. Be cautious using this feature as it can easily introduce problems with any simulation. If the objects are too tightly packed and will have no room, assets may be pushed off canvas and fall out of the simulation. Also, depending on the complexity of the physics shape, the calculations may take too long. The next category is physics. Here you get to control the gravity rules. Up, down, left, right, center, and edge. Use this to jostle your images into a better pack. By default, gravity is not applied. If you choose a gravity rule from the dropdown, it will automatically run it. You can enter into inertia again by selecting none. The next section is scaling, which you can set your scale ranges. The default scale is just 10% to match the default canvas size. The tool will randomly spawn an asset within the scale ranges you set. The rotation section sets the angle ranges upon spawn. 0 and 360 degrees are at the 12 o'clock position. You can also click lock, and the angle of the objects will not move. This is to achieve a certain look in a pattern. Alpha controls the alpha ranges. I'd like to call out a powerful feature in the pack tool. I saw this type of pattern usage in a lot of marketing material, and I wanted to mimic it, and have tried it on my own materials. Basically, you have what I call a hero feature, and you like to highlight that front and center. So to do that, you'll stuff the background with other related images, packing it tightly in place. Enfusoft allows you to right-click and select an asset and lock it. So in this case, I'm going to pick my teddy bear as my hero asset and lock it after I put it into place. After I lock the hero asset, I can then change my physics shape to be more accurate, so I choose outline. I'll expand my collision buffer to fill out the space, then run some gravity to jostle them all into position. I'll do a bit of curating, deleting duplicate or overlapping assets. This would have taken me much longer had I done this another way. The pack subtool is very interactive, which makes this the subtool that requires a lot of finesse. There are many ways to break this tool and its intended results, depending on how you use it. So here's one of my suggested paths of use. Spray items on canvas, use a sphere collision, then run a gravity simulation to help pack your images down. Then change the physics to outline to really pack it down. After that, adjust the collision buffer to fill out the space. We are planning and adding more powerful features in our next version. The third pattern type Enfusoft is designed to create is Toss. Toss is a quicker tool to use with fewer inputs. Canvas size. Set your desired canvas size. Layout. This number is the number of assets scattered on the canvas. Scaling. Set your scale ranges here. Rotation. Set your angle ranges here. Hit Generate to generate whole new random sets. When you adjust the scale or angle settings, the location of the assets don't change. When you change the item count, the pattern changes. When you change the canvas changes, but the location of the generated patterns do not. What's great about Toss is that the complex pattern is tiling in all directions. Zoom and pan to see your work up close. Thank you for watching Enfusoft's three-part tutorial series covering the basic three pattern types it creates. You can support our work by telling your designer friends and colleagues about this time-saving tool. You can download the free trial at Enfusoft.com. Thanks again for your attention and support.